I am Niharika, your English trainer for this lesson today. I'm so glad that you could make it for another lesson with me, because this will take you to the right approach to learning. Yeah, well, I guess the birds want to learn too, right? But you may wonder, what is the wrong approach then? Are you wondering? Well, you need to ask yourself a very honest question. When you have to answer a question in English, do you think about the answer in your native tongue? Or do you try to translate it in English? And do you get frustrated when you find out that this was just wasting your time and it actually didn't help you to learn? Yeah, because your English would not get any better if you think in your native language. Yes, you need to stop translating your native tongue and start thinking in English. Do you think it sounds easier than done? I don't think so. Because I'm going to show you a few steps that will teach you to think in English. And that will definitely increase your English fluency in no time. So stay tuned with me. Meanwhile, we discover how to learn English the right way. And firstly, you need to work out. No, I'm not talking about hitting the gym. I am talking about exercising your English language muscle. Yes, did you know that on an average, you might know at least minimum of 2 or 3 languages? So let's just assume that you were born in India and you grew up learning 3 languages. Now, which happen to be your native languages? And the 3rd language is English. Now, the first 2 languages get spoken the most because you speak them with your parents, with your friends, with the postman, with the driver, with the taxi driver. Now, just about everyone. So you are exercising the native language muscles in your brain. Now, because speaking any language excessively exercises the muscle of that particular language too. How about working out this for English too? Now, if you speak English only to your teacher in school, or probably just a span of 1 hour with your friends, are you gonna get fluent in English? Are you gonna be fluent enough? Therefore, the idea to train your English muscle to be used a lot more than you do. In order to do that, you need to first buy an online or probably an English dictionary. That will give you the meaning of words in English. Now, it doesn't translate into any other language. Yeah, make sure that it's purely an English dictionary. You will learn its meaning, and definitely this will help you to make a sentence too. Now, this is essential. Well, it means that you are going to get more exposure to English language because you're not only learning a new English word, but in your mind, you get a chance to think about it on how and where you can use this word in the right manner. Now, the more you indulge in that, the more you're working out the English muscles. So, that makes your English stronger. And of course, it makes you think more in English language than in your native language. Well, here's the next thing. Well, thinking in English. Now that you have already started working out that English muscle, well, try thinking in English too. Now to do that, you just need to come with scenarios that require you to think in a more responsible way. It means that your response should be in English. Take a piece of paper and imagine that you are at the airport. Now, if you have to board a flight, pen down the words that you will use in relation to this topic. After having done that, try to make sentences using these words. Yes. I mean, how would you use these words in your future conversations? So you think you can use sentences like, hey, I would like to take the window seat, please. Or if you are going to be in the flight and you see a flight attendant and you need something, try to practice that. Yes, English is based on anyone who believes that if you work out on the scenarios and be prepared, oh, your English conversations are going to be so much fun. Next is correcting yourself. So important. I mean, people think that when you are speaking in English, probably you're not making mistakes. Of course, we all do mistakes, be it learning a new language, learning a new skill, be it anything. But what's the integral part of learning? Well, you learn from your mistakes only if these mistakes are corrected. So since we are going to learn English, it is an important thing that we correct ourselves. Now, how do you do that? While you're practicing to think in English, if you feel that you have not understood the way a word has to be used, like the way a word has to be used in a sentence, or if you feel that the word could be used in more than one or two ways, oh, then sure, you can definitely try doing that. Make a list. Make a list of all the possible mistakes that you have made. Well, now you can show this list to probably your teacher, or to your friend, or to someone who is really good at English. Now, this person will help you to understand that what are the mistakes and how to use the language in the correct way. As you keep taking feedback from other people, and if you implement it, oh, your fluency, it's definitely gonna improve. In fact, in the next 6 months, you will be surprised at your sentence construction and your vocabulary and your confidence in speaking English. Next is practice speaking. Well, since you have learned to think in English and now you have also worked on correcting yourself with some help, you must now implement what you have learned, which means that it's now time to practice speaking in English with other people. Oh, don't be scared. Don't be embarrassed to make a fool out of yourself. If you are shy to try out your new speaking skills in front of strangers or in front of people, then try to find a partner. Well, someone whom you're comfortable with, your friend, your family, or someone who speaks good English. Yes, well, that is important. Even if it's your spouse or even if it's your child, speaking with other people always exposes you to new words and the different ways of saying things. So be it slangs, be it new phrases, be it new idioms, it also makes you aware of all the new words that people use on daily basis. This kind of a practice makes your conversations sound more real and more authentic, as you're actually talking to someone and not making up imaginary conversations. Moreover, speaking to other people also makes you more confident. So I would really suggest that if you talk to people, like have small talks with strangers or random people, oh, your fluency will be great. So people, thank you for watching this session with me. As you can see, that thinking and speaking in English is the best way to go about mastering this language. Now, many of my students have really accomplished this with, of course, a lot of hard work, a lot of efforts, and of course, a little bit of confidence. Because if you are nervous, things might be difficult for you. You won't be able to face the challenges. So please go through the points that we just discussed. Let me know if you would like to have some more help, or let me know if these points really helped you to speak in a better manner. I'll be back with a new session soon. Till then, you take care and keep watching us and keep learning.